Good afternoon, Mr. MercifulAndvary. You wanted to know what our little strange habits are with our pipes. I suppose I have two, and they kind of contradict each other. I'll show you. Three pipes. And the weirdness is, the first weirdness is, although I leave these out so that I can pick them up handy, I keep them handy, my weirdness is that I'm a freak about cleaning them. Every time I smoke a bowl, like this one that I'm about to finish, I'll clean the hell out of it. I'm getting to the bottom of this bowl, and when I do, I'll hit this with this brush lightly. And some people would say that I'm harming the habit or the hobby by removing the cake from the bowl, but I'm freakish about cleaning them. I hate the taste of a dirty pipe. Or let's say I burnt a bowl of something, which I'm liable to do sometimes. If I overpack it so that there's too much moisture in there, too much steam, the steam builds up, it begins to gurgle, and then I remove the moisture somehow, either with a pipe cleaner or by shaking it out a little bit. The whatever ash got trapped, maybe inside the draft tube, you know, will acquire that terrible forest fire taste that you come to when you've reached the bottom of a bowl and it's really residual and, you know, and then too wet. So, because that has happened to me too many times, I've become a freak about cleaning my pipes. I don't just tap them out and put them aside to the next use, but I have to clean it as if I'm going to sell it, you know. It's just a freakish habit that I have. That's number one weirdness. Number two weirdness is, for a guy who keeps his pipes clean, or too clean, I also have a habit of packing a pipe with, let's say, oh, I don't know, Mac Baron HH Old Dark Fired, which is what I smoke basically every day. While I'm working, I keep a pipe going, because I work over the phone, you know. So nobody knows I'm smoking it, but usually something like that. I'll get halfway down that bowl, nothing wrong with it, and decide, oh, I want something else. So I'll take this, and I'll put this pipe aside. And I'll pick up another one. And I'll pack that with some, oh, I don't know, Nightcap from Dunhill. Or, you know, Quiet Nights, my absolute favorite of all time. Other GL pieces. Ones that I know I'm going to be hitting a lot. Arango Balkan Supreme. And I'll pack a bowl of that. And I will smoke that halfway down. Loving it the whole time. And then I'll say, or I'll let it go out. And as I'm reaching for the lighter to relight it, I'll say, wait. No, I want something else. But do I go back to my half bowl of HH Old Dark Fired? No. I grab a third pipe or a fourth pipe, and I'll pack that with something. Who knows? Maybe I'm up for something a little bit aromatic, some Lane 1Q, some Cult Tobacco, some Scotty's Butternut Burley from Pipes and Cigars. Maybe I want something sweet, so I'll pack a bowl of that. Same thing. Well, I rarely, if ever, will leave four pipes lying around. But I am liable to leave two or three. So for a guy who likes to keep his pipes freakishly clean, I also leave them full a lot. So I suppose that's my weirdness. Other than that, I mean, I guess I'm pretty much like anybody else. I do, however, identify you with you about pipes that aren't perfectly symmetrical when they're supposed to be. I have a Savinelli 315 Meerschaum lined pipe that I love. It's probably my most elegant pipe, and I leave it in my back office because I most often smoke that one when I'm working. But it's not completely round. I don't have it with me right now, but let's say this was it. The bowl is not perfectly symmetrical. The bowl, if you're looking at it down this way, is heavier on this side. And when the pipe sits, and it does sit, it will lean a little bit to that side because of the weight. Constant reminder that it's not symmetrical. And as I smoke it, I never think to myself, I'm smoking my beautiful Savinelli 315 Meerschaum lined, you know, beautifully polished briar pipe. No. I think to myself, I'm smoking my poor Savinelli that's not symmetrical. And I just know it the whole time. So I do identify with that. But those are probably the most weirdnesses that I have. Otherwise, I mean, we acquire weirdnesses because we love the things so much. If we didn't care about them, we wouldn't even notice such things. So anyway, that's my video reply to your question about what strange habits do we have. I'm kind of curious, without researching you too deeply, are you in Russia? Or some part of it? Are you able to get these American or British-made pipes as easily? Is it hard to get them? I'm just kind of curious. But for you to be able to give away one that's pretty nice, I got to wonder how hard it was for you to acquire it in the first place. And how much work there will be for you in sending it to somebody if they win it in the States. I know you mentioned something about sending them out, and that it's a labor, I suppose. But anyway, it's great of you to offer one at all like that. So, that in mind, it becomes a more valuable gift. So anyway, that's my reply for now. I'll kill it right here. But it's already gone on too long. But thank you for the opportunity to reply to your giveaway. And so you know. That's it. Have a great day.